welcome to the Jim and Joyce Faulkner Performing Arts Center at the University of Arkansas. At this time, we ask that you please silence all electronic devices as to not interfere with the performers on stage or the recording of the performance. We also ask that you refrain from flash photography. On behalf of the Department of Music, please enjoy the performance.
Good evening. Wow, it's such a pleasure to be here with you tonight. Chris Knighton and his wife Jan have been dear friends for many years. Chris and I taught at East Carolina University and together and been working with these fine musicians that you're going to hear in a few moments while they work so hard, and it's been such a pleasure to see them grow through these pieces. The first piece you're going to hear tonight is a new work for me called Przebudzenie. It means the awakening, and that's Polish, Przebudzenie. My wife is Polish, I have family in Poland, and I've been working as an artistic director for the largest percussion festival in Europe called Drumfest, which is in Opole, Poland. 2 years ago, they had their 25th anniversary, and I decided to write a fanfare to commemorate this anniversary. And it's not just that they did something for 25 years, it's when you realize the situation that Poland became free from the communist rule in 1989 before the Berlin Wall went down. They were leaders in this area, and the fact that this gentleman, Wojtek Lasek, who was the host of Drumfest, started this competition and festival just a year or two later after that was a really amazing foresight. And so this piece is about the rising of people out of dire circumstances and really building a beautiful life there and an amazing festival. So the work opens with chimes that are in recognition of Opole's cathedral, because when you're near the cathedral and the chimes go off, you can't really hear or talk or do anything else. They're so loud and so powerful. So that's how the piece begins, and then you'll hear a fanfare. And this is a short celebration of that music and that festival. Enjoy.
Thank you.
planning on speaking, but I decided in the middle of that last piece that I had to. The last time I was with David Meslink, I was the guest clinician for the University of Montana conducting symposium, and I had lunch with David. We were just chatting. He's gone from the earth now. I'm sure he was enjoying that piece from wherever he is. It started this nostalgia in my head, and I started thinking about the first time I met Dale Warren, and it was in 1992, I think, maybe 93, 91. And we went golfing together. Get him to tell you that story because it's quite interesting. Then I started thinking about the first time I met Jamal Duncan, and that was 17 years ago. And the first time I met Ben, the first time I met Dr. Knighton, and first time I met Mark Ford was in 1986. And all this might mean is that I'm old, but we live in a noisy world. I talk to the ensemble members. They call me maestro when I go international destinations to conduct, and the word maestro means teacher. The word ensemble means together, we. And I just wanted to say that if we ever needed togetherness, and if you're listening online, there's probably many conductors and band directors listening or watching as well, and large ensembles are under assault by curricula and just value sets in school of musics across the country. And if we've ever needed togetherness more than we do in 2018, I don't know when that has ever been, at least in my almost 50 years. So if there's any kind of value that is attributed to togetherness, then I think tonight you're seeing beautiful evidence of why music is so profoundly important. This next piece is as beautiful as they come, and this was making me think of Bob Reynolds that I met, I don't know, 40 years ago, 30 years ago, and it's amazing, and music is transformative, and it's really important that we not forget that. Also, lastly, I'll say, I'm just the state north, I'm in Kansas City. If you ever want to come say hi to me, please do. We'll treat you really wonderfully, I hope, with welcome and open arms. It's a pleasure to be on your campus. I look forward to the next 3 days. Please enjoy the dance.
Thank you.
asked me to say a few words about Stubernick. And Stubernick is originally a marimba trio. And it came about because a good friend of mine, Stefan Stuber, around 1986-87, he went down to Nicaragua to do humanitarian aid work. This is when the United States and Nicaragua were having skirmishes with Noriega, for those of you that might remember this little tidbit of history. It was very much more than a tidbit to those people there, and my friend Stefan did a lot of great work helping the people there at that time. And he came back and he told me all these amazing stories about where he'd been, and of course in Guatemala, in neighboring countries in Guatemala. And because of that, I decided to write this piece for him, and I put three people on the instrument, just like they would in Guatemala with marimba bands. Unlike United States, each village in Guatemala has a marimba band. It's a beautiful place. And they sometimes have three to five players on each instrument. So I decided to write this piece for him and dedicate it to him. So it's Stuber, Stefan Stuber, for his last name, Nick, for Nicaragua. Stuber Nick, I thought that sounded pretty cool. Stuber Agua sounded like a bad Italian dish, so I'll have the Stuber Agua, please. Okay. This particular rendition, I was asked, actually a good friend of mine, Eugene Corporon, who is a great conductor of wind ensembles at North Texas, asked me to write a piece for his wind symphony there, and it took me like 10 years to get to it, but I finally put this piece together, Stubernick Fantasy, dedicated it to Maestro Corporon, and we premiered it at the wind ensemble version at the Midwest Festival in Chicago. I won't talk anymore. I'm so happy to play with my dear friend Chuck Ragsdale over there, who I've known for many years, also an ECU connection with our dear teacher Harold Jones. And I'm so delighted to meet Fernando Valencia, who's playing with me here as well. Just two great players, and of course to play with this awesome ensemble. So please enjoy Stubernick Fantasy.
Thank you. Thank you.